So let us recall what we have did in the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we were discussing about the solution of Bessel's equation. A Bessel's equation is written, or it can be expressed as x square y double s plus x y dash plus x square minus p square y equal to zero, where p is greater than or equal to zero. Now to write the solution of this Bessel's equation, we will have, or we got the solution, it is in the form of a Bessel's function. So the Bessel's function is denoted as jp of x, which is summation n running from 0 to infinity, minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into n plus p factorial plus x by 2 power 2n plus p. This is known as a Bessel's function of first kind of order p, where the value of p is greater than or equal to 0. To extend this n plus p factorial for the any real number, we have also extended the definition of this jp of p, that is, in terms of a gamma function, we have able to write down this Jacobian in terms of a gamma function. And so this Bessel's function is true for any, in general, value of p. And then we have discussed some properties of this Jacobian function or Bessel's function. That is, the first property we have discussed is this Bessel's function j minus m x is linearly dependent with j m of x. That means these two Bessel's functions are linearly dependent and they have this relation. And then we have discussed the solution for this Bessel's equation. The solutions for Bessel's equation, if p is not integer, then the solution is y is equal to c1 jp of x plus c2 jp j minus p of x, if p is not integer. If p is an integer, then the solution is of the form c1 jp of x plus c2 y m of x, where p is equal to m. And this value of ym is the limit of jp of yp of x, where p is tending to m, where yp of x is of the form cos p pi jp of x minus j minus p of x upon sine p pi. So with that, we have also discussed zeros of jp, j 0 and j 1. That is, the first condition we have proved is derivative of j 0 of x will be minus of j 1 of x, and the derivative of x into j 1 of x is x into j 0 of x. Using this property, we have proved that in between zeros of j 0, there is a zeros of j 1 is there, and in between the zeros of j 1, there is a zero of j 0 is there. So with the in the previous lecture, we have discussed up to then this. Now we have to discuss certain recurrence relation for this Bessel's function. That is our objective in this lecture to discuss. It's the recurrence relation of jp of x. So the first one that we have is the first derivative of x raised to p jp of x is equal to x raised to p j p minus 1 of x. Let us try to prove this one. So I'll start with this side. Let's say I'm starting with LHS, that is the left hand side, that is d by dx of x raised to p jp of x. And as per the definition, this is summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into p plus n factorial into x by 2 power 2n plus p, and into x power p is there, because this x power p is already there. So this can be written as d by dx of summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into n plus p factorial x power 2n plus 2p upon 2 power 2n plus p. If I differentiate this quantity, we will have summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into n plus p factorial 2n plus 2p into x power 2n plus 2p minus 1 upon 2 power 2n plus p. Now here we can note that this n plus p is cancelled out. So we will have that d by dx of x raised to p jp of x will be summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into n plus p into n plus p minus 1 factorial, and the numerator you will have 2 into n plus p, because you can see that 2 into n plus p, and this n plus p factorial I can factorize into 2 factor, and this quantity writing as it is, that is x power 2n plus p minus 1 into x power p I am writing separately upon 2 power 2n plus p. Now this, you can just check out, this n plus p is cancelled out. 1, 2 is cancelled with this 2. So this is finally, we have x raised to p I am taking out. Summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n is there upon n factorial n plus, or I can say that it is p minus 1 plus n factorial, then it is x by 2 power 2n plus p minus 1. So instead of p we have minus 1 here, that we can observe. So this is nothing but the x power p into j p minus 1 of x. So that completes the first recurrence relation. Now we have a next one, that is the second. In that we have to prove that d by dx of x power minus p jp of x is x power minus p jp plus 1 of x. This is our second recurrence relation. So I'll start with here also in this side, that is LHS, that is d by dx of x power minus p jp p of minus x is equal to d by dx of summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into p plus n into n factorial, then x by 2 power 2n plus p is there. So this x power minus p is multiplied, so it is 2n plus p minus p upon 2 power 2n plus p is already there. So this is d by dx of summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into p plus n factorial into x power 2n upon 2 power 2n plus p. If we differentiate this, we will have summation n running from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into p plus n factorial 2n into 2 power 2n minus 1 upon 2n plus p. Now one should note that this 1n is cancelled out. This is n minus 1 factorial is left here. And this 1, 2 is cancelled out with this. So we'll have minus 1 easier. So this will gives you, this is equal to, that is d by dx of x power minus p into jp of x, where summation running from 1 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon, this is n minus 1 factorial e plus n factorial, 2 is cancelled out, so it is x minus x raised to 2n minus 1. Upon 2 power 2n plus p minus 1. That is the things we got. Now here the summation is starting with 1, running from 1 to infinity. Because when we differentiate this, it was start with 1. Because the first term, when you substitute 0 here, the first term is a constant term into this series. So that's why when you differentiate that constant term, it will become 0. So that's why this is start with 1. So if I want to convert this is from 0, then I have to replace n by n minus 1, n plus 1. So if you replace n by n plus 1, this running from 1 to, now it is running from 0, this will be n minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon n factorial minus 1 n factorial p plus n plus 1 factorial. So you will have, this is p plus n, because instead of n we have to write down n plus 1. So this is x power 2 into n plus 1 minus 1. In the denominator, you will have 2 power 2n plus 2 plus p minus 1. So if you simplify this one, you can write down this is 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n plus 1 upon. So this minus 1 raised to n, that I am taking minus 1 out. That I'm writing minus out 2 to this n plus, this is n plus n factorial. This is p plus 1 plus n factorial I can write. And this one will be x power 2n plus 1 upon, in the denominator you will have this is 2n plus p plus 1. So what we will do now here, I'm adding and I'm multiplying and divide by x power p here. That is x power minus p into x power p, I'm multiplying and adding, or multiplying and dividing. This x power p I'm taking out. So this is equal to minus of x power minus p in the summation n running from 0 to infinity minus 1 raised to n upon n factorial into p plus 1 plus n factorial. This x power p combined with this one, we can write x power 2n plus p plus 1, and divided by 2 is also there. So here you can just see that in the definition of this jp of x, instead of p we have, this is p plus 1. So finally what we can have, this is minus x power minus p j p plus 1 of x is there. So that completes the proof of the second recurrence relation. Now the third one is prove that jp dash of x plus p by x jp of x is equal to jp minus 1 of x. Here z dash will represent the first derivative. Now to prove this one, we will use the previous one of the recurrence relation which we have derived, that you can just observe here we have derived that d by dx of x power p jp of x is equal to x power p jp minus 1 of x. So we will use that result here. So now we have d by dx of x power p jp of x equal to x power p jp minus 1 of x. Now if I apply this d by dx here as a product rule, then therefore this will can write down as jp is as it is, this is jp dash of x plus p into x raised to p minus 1. That is the first function as it is, the derivative of the second one, and then derivative of the second one, that is derivative of x power p is p into x raised to p minus 1, and jp of x is as it is equal to x power p jp minus 1 of x, and then you multiply by x power p both side. So dividing, not multiply, dividing by x power p, we get jp dash of x plus p by x jp of x is equal to jp minus 1 of x. So that completes the proof of the second also. Using this also we can have for the second things we have discussed, that is prove that jp minus x minus p by x jp of x is equal to minus of jp plus 1 of x. Here we can use the second identity which we have proved, that is d by dx of x power minus p of x. So to prove this one, we'll start with that. So we have d by dx of x power minus p jp of x is equal to x power minus of x power minus p jp plus 1 of x. Now using this product rule of the derivative, we can write down x raised to p minus p is as it is jp dash of x, that is the derivative of this function, and then plus minus p into x power minus p minus 1 jp of x equal to x raised to p jp plus 1 of x as it is. Now we can divide both side by x power minus p, we get jp of dash of minus x plus, this plus will become minus, now p by x xp or jp of x is equal to jp plus 1 of x, which completes the proof of this second, this fourth recurrence relation. Now the fifth one is prove that JP 2 times JP dash of x is equal to JP minus 1 of x minus JP plus 1 of x. I can give you this as a homework, but let me give you a hint. You will just, this is the homework I'm saying. You may just see what is the third identity which we have proved. The third identity is we have proved is JP dash of x plus P by x JP of x is equal to JP minus 1 of x. So this is my hint. This is the third equation, third three we have proved, that is this. And in the equation fourth we have did this. So we can also, these are the hint you can follow. Minus P by x JP of x is equal to minus of JP plus 1 of x. Now using this 3 and 4, you can prove the fifth one. I'm not going to discuss that one here. You can prove it yourself. And the sixth one is also I'm giving you as a homework. That is JP of x into P by x 2 times equal to JP minus 1 of x plus JP plus 1 of x. Here is also hint is equation 3 and 4. Just look at the equation 3 and 4 and try to prove the fifth one and the sixth one yourself. So these are the recurrence relation which I have discussed already. If you have any question regarding this, you can ask.